If the baby's crying, we get up as a feed, we feed together. Everything is a duet. This is not how my father and mother worked it. If I was crying, my father would go, get it! I gotta work!
What are we doing with these names, America? Like, why mess with normal names? No one thinks we're from old line British money. Like, Huxton, I'm sorry, are you a hotel lobby? What are these words? Liston, Blixen, Dasher, Dancer, Braxton, Hicks, Contraction, come here. But it wasn't until I got pregnant that first time that I became personally in tune with how often women are asked about children. Prior to that, no one had ever asked me about children because I'm a stand-up comic.
Well, you'll just die in a clown suit somewhere on a regional flight, won't you?
But I realize how often people ask women about this. I didn't get that before, right? Now, it's totally normal and innocuous to ask a woman, do you have kids? It's an okay thing to ask because it's, we'll call it traditional. Someone had kids, it's why we're all in this room, right? It's totally traditional for two humans, regardless of gender, to put their bodies together and then through means of sex, science, or trade, acquire smaller humans that they then put in their home and then subsequently put to work. Okay. That's what's done. It's a little less traditional to be like, we're in a throuple and this is our tortoise, but okay.
My son Frankie is now 19 years old. 19 years old, high school graduate. He has all his shots, ladies. People tell me all the time, you know, why do you talk about your son so much? Because he won't leave. Does he like it when you talk about him? I said, no, he hates it. Well, why do you do it? Because he won't leave. I'll tell you what he likes to do right now. He likes to sit around the house and watch videos of other kids playing video games. See, some of you are clapping. I didn't know that was an actual thing. I asked him, what are you doing? I'm watching other kids playing video games. I said, that's really? Why? Well, they're professionals. I'm like, why would you watch something that you could be doing? Because they're professionals. That's dumb. Really, Dad? Every Sunday, I see you watching football. How come you don't play? I didn't even argue. I just cut off the internet.
I made a horrible business decision. I got married and had two children. Horrible idea. I love them, but they just grow and get bigger and need more money and more money. At this point, it's like I'm living with two unemployed coke addicts. Seriously, they come into my office every morning. Hey, you got more money for me? What happened to the change from yesterday? I don't know, the economy, right? And I spoil them. I spoil the hell out of them. Because they're girls. They're two girls, so forget it. They got me. Yo, they got me. I hope they don't watch this and realize. No, they got me. And you know, my father had money, but he didn't spoil us, so I'm going the other way, you know? My father made money, but he's like, I'm not going to give it to children. I'm going to spend it on what I want to spend it on. Could you imagine living in a time where the children weren't in charge? Sounds like a magical time to be alive. To be honest, I don't want them to leave. It's going to be rough. I don't want to see them go. No, it's fun. It's all for, you know, they're not even that great. And I want them to be around. We have a mean girl. We have a mean girl. Yeah, I didn't know they were real. They're real. Yeah, I feel guilty. I made it. I feed it. I'm keeping it alive. I give it money. It's like I'm funding the terrorists. But it is complicated because I can't tell how mean she is. Like when we were little, if you were a bad kid, they came right up to your father at school. Hey, you got a shitty one here. And your father was grateful that an adult was talking to him. Thank you, I'll beat him immediately. Now they'll get fired if they say that, so it's confusing. I can't tell how mean she is, you know, and I love her, so it's all... I'm sure at some point, Hitler's parents must have turned to each other like, he's a little weird, right? Yeah, he's weird. He's six. Who has a mustache like that? It's six. But you know, this is all a part of it. You want to prepare your kids for life, but it's hard, right? We're not really prepared for life. It's hard. Like I said, everybody's complaining, feeling like they're not doing all right. You're doing great. You're doing great. I promise you. I don't say that lightly, my friends. I don't. I don't know any of you, and I'm telling you, you're doing great. I'll go one better. You're peaking right now.
So I said, I got an idea. I take Frankie to Walmart. We get to Walmart, and Frankie goes, what are we doing here? I got it, watch. We walk in. I said, grab a cart. Follow me. And I lead Frankie all the way to the candy section. Well, as soon as we get to the candy section, I stop the cart. And I got in Frankie's face, and I said, Frankie, you have exactly 30 seconds to grab as much candy as you can. Ready? Go! And he froze. I said, dude, clock's ticking. You better move. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. So he grabs a bag, looks at it, throws it in the cart. Grabs a second bag, looks at it, throws it in the cart. Grabs a third bag, and on the third bag, time! And it was the first time I heard him go, shit. Because he knew he wasted that golden opportunity those first few seconds. So we get to the car. I rip open the three bags. I dump them out in his bucket, and I tell him, look, Frankie, when we get home, you cannot tell your mom that we went to Walmart. Why not? Because she's gonna say that we cheated trick-or-treating. But it's better. I know it's better. So we get home, and it, of course, now it's a different tone. She's like, there you are. Did you guys have a good time? We had a great time, baby. We had a good time, huh, Frankie? That's good. Frankie, give me your candy. Why, Mom? Because I need to go through your candy to make sure it's safe for you to eat. Why wouldn't it be safe? It all came from... Cállate, pendejo. Cállate. Cállate, cabrón. He almost took down the empire, you know what I'm saying? So he hands over the bucket, and she grabs it and immediately dumps it out on the table right in front of us. She notices, you know? There's a lot of the same candy right here. A lot of the same candy. Can you explain why there's so much of the same candy in Frankie's bucket? I don't know what to tell you, baby. There's a lot of basic bitches in this neighborhood. You know, just kind of, I don't know. We can't go back to that other neighborhood because they got cameras and they're going to know us. And that, we don't want to be that person. Nobody wants to be that.
We get that next question that you always get when you're newly married. Everybody wants to know if we're having kids. And I'll tell you, parents, you are not making it look fun. You guys all have a glaze in your eyes. Just... So we're dog moms right now. That's what we're doing. And we'll see what happens.
And I didn't even know if I was going to look. But it's hard not to. My wife's Jewish, right? So the baby starts coming out. I saw jet black hair. I'm like, babe, I think the Italian penetrated the Jew. I think we got an Italian Catholic baby. Little ear came out. That's when I lost it. As soon as I saw my daughter's ear come out, I'm like, babe, I can't believe it. This is unbelievable. And then more heads started to come. And then more head. Now I'm like, what the hell is wrong with that? Nobody told me it comes out like a football. So I'm... My wife's like, is she cute? I'm like, she's gonna have some problems in school with the other kids. Did you save the receipts for the hats that we bought? They're not gonna fit on this cone. It's all fucked up down here. I don't know what's going on. Nobody told us. So my wife checks the baby. She's like, she's got a stuffed up nose. Now babies can't blow their own nose. I didn't notice. I thought they just, and then, you know, sneeze and shit came out. I'm like, I didn't know that we had an assist in this. My wife gives me this apparatus. It's like a bullet you put in the nostril, and there's a hose attached, and you're at the other end. And I go, babe, what do you want me to? You want me to suck the snot out of her nose, and then swallow that? I'll do it if that's what this requires. But shouldn't we read the box or Google it? So here I am, 3 a.m., in my underwear, with the tube up my daughter. My wife's like, what's wrong? She goes, there's supposed to be a filter. I go, there's no filter. I got it. I got it right here. I got it right here.
That's the kind of world we live in. It's so fucked up, man. And your timid and lame ways, that shit is trickling down to your kids, man. Your kids is lame as fuck right now. Got your kid thinking everything he does is great and everything everybody else does is wrong and he the most beautifulest and the most talented. But then when he get in the real world and we let him know he sucked dick, all of a sudden he on medication. Be real with your kids. Let them know everybody drawing can't go on the refrigerator. Some of that shit is drawer bound, goddammit.
You single people, you don't have to go on a play date, which is basically a blind date that your toddler sets you up on with some bitch you have zero chemistry with. People, you don't have to be nice to your mother because you need her for babysitting. You don't have to smile and listen to all of this unsolicited parenting advice from this woman who neglected the shit out of you. Because you want time to yourself to binge Bridgerton to feel alive again.
Everybody wished. And boy, we got what we wished for. How many parents were rubbing that lamp? Wishing away. Oh, I wish I could spend more time with my kids. Oh, oh.
Your wish is granted.
Yeah, a lot of parents realize the only reason you like your kids is because you only know them part-time. You meet them in the morning, you send them off, you tuck them in at night, it's a pretty sweet gig. But then the next thing you know, everyone was trapped indoors, 24/7. Ooh, it was so fun to watch the parents flip. It was so fun. Remember at the beginning? All the parents were there. They're like, you will not open the schools. My children are not going anywhere. I will protect them at all costs. I'm a mama bear and I'll protect my cubs. You hear me? You will not open the schools until the virus is gone.
9 months later.
Those same parents were there screaming on the stoop. When are the goddamn schools opening? You can't expect me to spend all day with these kids. Who am I, their mom? They should be in school. The kids were there like, but mommy, there's a new variant out there. Listen, Timmy, listen. At some point, you're going to have to see what you're made of, okay? Either your lungs are going to make it or they ain't. All right, buddy? Now get on out there and see what you're made of, all right? If Simba could do it, so could you. Hakuna Matata. Go on, buddy. Go on.